Order 66 was the massacre orchestrated by Palpatine to rid his new empire of the Sith's ancient enemy, the Jedi, allowing him to take full control. Now, as we know, this was a brutal purge that resulted in the deaths of thousands of not just Jedi warriors and generals, but also Padawans and younglings, the most innocent of the entire order. And although Palpatine was almost a fully fledged authoritarian at this point, it's hard to imagine how any of this could have been claimed to be done legally. So, just how legal was Order 66, and how did Sidious get away with this massive controversy scot-free at the very beginning of his rule? Now, the natural answer to this is that Sidious became Emperor, basically right after this event, so he couldn't really be held accountable for these crimes. And although this is true in many ways, and it definitely helped, it's not exactly accurate. During the early days of his rise to power, he still had to an extent, lean on Senate approval to do what he needed. At the end of the day, if the entire Senate refused his position as Emperor, then he would have struggled to claim it. Not only this, but the inhibitor chips and the contingency orders that he used needed to remain a secret from the public, or it would have cast a great amount of suspicion upon him, and again put his new title of Emperor in danger. So basically what he needed to do was rationalise this massacre and make it legal. So we know that Order 66 marks the Jedi as traitors to the Republic, and all the Jedi leadership are now able to be executed for treason. However, this only specifies the Jedi leadership, meaning the knights, the warriors, those who are actively involved. But that doesn't explain whilst every other Jedi was also able to be killed. Now, we know that during the Clone Wars, the Jedi somewhat became a functioning part of the Grand Army of the Republic, taking on the ranks of general and commander. For this reason, they are now subject to the same practices and code of conduct as anyone else in the military. And it's important to know that although originally the Republic didn't allow capital punishment or execution, the Republic military during the Clone Wars did. What this suggests is that the Jedi were integrated into the military more as an organization over an individual. So basically, if you were part of the Jedi Order, then you were also part of the Grand Army of the Republic. Even if you openly disputed the war or didn't partake in any battles, being affiliated with the Jedi Order instantly also put you in the Grand Army of the Republic. At least that's what is suggested here. The Jedi could in no way still class as civilians. Which is one of the reasons why Ahsoka's attempted execution at the hands of the 501st was quite controversial, because technically she was no longer part of the Jedi Order. So was she a civilian? Was she still a Jedi? It was quite difficult for them to say. Now, the ultimate goal of this was to allow this new empire to condemn the Jedi as a group, as opposed to just the leadership and just individuals. So, if you're a Jedi, you are also a co-conspirator in this treachery. Now, the real question here is, does this somewhat count as a war crime? Well, yes and no. We're going to be taking quite a few guesses here, as what constitutes a war crime in the Star Wars galaxy isn't exactly clear, but generally speaking, enemy combatants are treated as POWs, meaning you can't just execute them. However, the Jedi were not enemy combatants, they were traitors. So, I looked at a real-world example. Here I looked at the United States military, being the biggest military in the world, and capital punishment is still actually a possibility here, although it hasn't been used for a very long time. Now, there's a list of reasons why somebody can be executed within the military, and two of the reasons that stood out to me were mutiny or espionage. Now, what Sidious was accusing the Jedi of was attempting to launch a coup to take power, and this would have meant that it was, by its very nature, mutiny and espionage. And since the Jedi were still technically members of the GAR, then technically speaking, there is some very, very narrow legal precedence in theory that could say that the execution of the Jedi was legal. Again, that's a lot of theory there. We don't really know that much about the legislation in the Star Wars universe, but yeah, let's just get on with it. Okay, so essentially what we are saying is that there is a very, very slim case that the attack on the Jedi was legal. However, in reality, it would probably never have been allowed to happen under normal circumstances. But these weren't really normal circumstances. We would expect at least a few hundred of the Jedi to have been arrested out of the thousands, at least some of the younglings, you know, But here's how Sidious gets around this. He has very little oversight. So he ordered the attack on the Jedi Temple, and the only people who went to the Jedi Temple during this attack were those who were completely loyal to him, either Anakin Skywalker or 501st troops. The Jedi Temple was locked down to stop anyone from showing up or anyone escaping, but I think this is more to stop anybody from turning up and saying, yo, is there any Jedi here, and seeing clones just butcher Jedi, because technically that is illegal. Even if the Jedi were traitors, they were still entitled to a trial or a court-martial. So basically, no one was there to argue the fact that what was happening was not an arrest, but actually a massacre. For this reason, he was able to argue that every single Jedi in the temple was hostile, and no one could argue any different because there was no proof, as no one else entered. Essentially, whilst the clones were butchering the Jedi because of the order, to the Senate and to the rest of the galaxy, it just looked like a raid had gone wrong. Officially, it was probably sold as the 501st were sent there to arrest and remove the Jedi from their position, and in return, the Jedi were the aggressors and started to attack the clones, which resulted in them being wiped out. And as we know, Palpatine continued to keep the Jedi Temple on lockdown for the foreseeable future before turning it into his own palace, so nobody could get any evidence suggesting otherwise, because what you would probably say is that the Jedi Temple in this scenario would be a crime scene. Ultimately, although Order 66 was illegal in countless different ways, the way that it was set up so efficiently by Sidious made it appear to be completely legal. The Jedi were willing members of a group, they were willing members of the military, and therefore they had to act within the laws and the regulations, and as we know, the GAR is able to dish out capital punishment. It's just something that they are legally allowed to do. Now, the means in which they did it are shady, but again, we need to consider the fact that Palpatine probably put a lot of effort in post his rise to Emperor into covering up what he'd done and making sure no one spoke out about it. But what do you guys think? How technically legal was Order 66? And how do you think Sidious stopped anyone from finding out the truth? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you for watching, I really do hope that you enjoyed this video. If so, please remember to like, share and sub, as it is really appreciated and it helps the channel grow. Also, don't forget to follow me on Twitter at TheLoreGuy for regular updates, and tick the bell. But most importantly, thank you so much for watching. I really do hope that you enjoyed this video. I had a lot of fun making it, and I'll see you next time.